Please welcome my guest, Roman Reigns. Roman, how are you?
Good. How you doing, brother?
Good. First off, amazing match at WrestleMania, the main event against Brock Lesnar. Tell us, what was it like to finally step inside the ring with the Beast?
You know, first and foremost, it is a huge honor to be just a part of the main event in WrestleMania. And with that being said, the magnitude of the moment, my plan, you know, I came out swinging, ready to take anything and everything, and that's exactly what happened. I came out swinging, I hit Brock right in the mouth, he picks me up, and next thing you know it, I'm going on a ride. He threw me all across the ring, dropped me on my neck a few times, and that's the territory when you step in the ring with the Beast. I think I showed a lot of people I'm willing to take a beating. I knew what it was. I knew it was going to be brutal. I stepped in that ring. I got knocked down. But I picked myself up every single time. I dusted my ass off and I got right back in the fight.
Describe the strategy you had heading into the match.
When you step in there with the Beast, you have to ride that Brock Lesnar wave. He took me on a hell of a ride. I visited Suplex City, as he'll call it, and I think I made a stop in every borough. German suplex, you know, belly to back Saito suplex, fisherman hook suplex, every single way he could have picked me up and slammed me, he did it. He did it. But I don't think he was ready for when I hit him in the mouth. I don't think he had a counter for my counter. I rode that wave. I survived it. I'm one of the only guys in the world that can say he survived Suplex City. I liked it there. I'm thinking about buying a condo there. He wasn't ready for me. Because when I fired up and I hit him right there in the mouth, he didn't have an answer. I hit him and I hit him and I hit him and finally I knocked him down. When it comes down to it, I changed Brock Lesnar's face with this. I changed his appearance permanently.
Well, speaking of face, multiple times during the match, you actually smiled and even laughed at Brock Lesnar. What kind of message were you trying to send?
That's what it was, man. That's the type of fight it was. These type of fights, you don't see them often for a reason. That fight, that changed my life. That fight, it changed Brock's life. We won't be the same. Things are different now. He was smacking the piss out of me. Trying to knock me down and keep me out for good. When you get to that point, you're doing a lot more than sending a message. He smacked me. I got back up. He smacked me again. I spit out blood. And I got back up. He smacked me again. I got back up and I smiled in his face. Brock Lesnar legitimately could not knock out Roman Reigns.
Well, obviously now we know, Roman, that neither yourself or Brock would leave WrestleMania with the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. Talk to me about that moment where I'm sure you thought you had Brock beat. Then here comes Seth Rollins, curb stomps you, and essentially takes away your dream.
It was terrible. It's right there. I was right there. I climbed the mountain. I felt the top. I was looking down, and I got pulled right off of it in a matter of moments. That's Seth Rollins. That was his job, and that's what he did. He had the money in the bank briefcase with a contract that he could cash in at any time, and what a perfect time. Let the animals take each other out and pick the bones. That's what he did. But I did something too. I told the whole world that I can and I will beat Brock Lesnar, and I could have. I'm telling you, this close, 30 more seconds. 30 more seconds, and it only would take a couple more of these to fire off. And then I'll bury this right in his chest. A couple more seconds. When it comes to Seth Rollins, I've beaten him before. So I can, I have, and I will beat him again.